Hello, let's have a look at what binary shifting means and what it's used for. So what is it used for? Well, if we want to multiply or divide a binary number by a power of 2, we can do this really, really quickly by shifting digits. There is such a thing as binary multiplication and binary division, and there are methods to do this, but comparatively, it's quite slow. Shifting, as we'll see, is quite a simple process and will quickly do the process for you. So if you're multiplying by something like 28 by 4, that is eligible to use a binary shift because 4 is a power of 2, because 2 to the power 2 is 4. Another example would be something like 17 being multiplied by 8. Well, 17 isn't a power of 2. Another is 28, by the way, but 8 is a power of 2 because 2 to the power 3 is 8. I can also divide. 45 isn't a power of 2. As long as your second number is, I can do it. 16 is 2 to the power 4. And another fun example, 128 is 2 to the power 7. So all of these are eligible for using a shift as opposed to a slightly longer formal multiplication or division method. To give you some non-examples which couldn't use shifting, I can't multiply 17 by 6 with a shift because 6 isn't a power of 2 and neither is 17. I also can't divide 16 by 5. 16 is a power of 2 because 2 to the power 4 is 16. However, 5 isn't, and in division, the second number is the important one to be a power of 2. So shifting is very fast for a CPU to do, and to be honest, very fast for you as a human to do as well. But two types of shifts. The first one is a left shift. A left shift will multiply a binary number by 2. In other words, it will double it. Well, how do we perform a left shift? What we do is we always add a zero at the LSB end. LSB is short for least significant bit. If I've got a binary number like 1011, what bit here is our LSB, our least significant bit? Well, it's the one with the lowest place value, which is our right-hand side one. So it's this end we're looking at. Now, if I was to do a left shift of 1, that means I need to add a 0 at this right-hand side end. So I'm going to add a 0. Let me line it up just to make it easier to maybe visualize. Let's add a 0 at this end. Then I'm just going to copy my number as it was before. The number grows in size by one digit because I stick a 0 on the right-hand side. Now, if we converted both numbers to deanery, we could see this effect in action. The top number is 11. The bottom number is 22. We can see it's multiplied by 2. It's doubled. I mean, keep doing this. If I was to apply a second left shift, so I was doing a left shift of 2 on this original number, I would now have 2 zeros at this right-hand side. And it grows even further. This number is now 44. So a left shift multiplies by 2, a right shift divides by 2. But an additional thing to understand about a right shift is it doesn't only divide by 2, but we also remove any fractional part the answer would have. And this has the result of potentially a loss of precision. That means the answer isn't necessarily the correct one. It may lose some data when I cut off my fractional part. So let me show you this in action, but just to say how we do this, first of all, a right shift doesn't add a digit, add a bit, like a left shift does. This time it removes a bit. It's still at the same end, but it removes as opposed to adding, which again explains why we lose some precision because I'm deleting some information. So let's pick a different binary number. Let's do 1010. Well, to perform a single right shift, well, how do I perform this? Well, I remove a bit at the LSB end. So this zero is getting removed. I could just scribble it out. But let me show why it's called a right shift, because this one is really shifting across to where the zero is, because the zero is now gone. This zero is shifting across, and this one is shifting across. That's why it's called a right shift. Digits are moving to the right. Effectively, this zero has been deleted. This guy is now gone. This original number was 10 in deanery. And this next number is 5 in deanery. Our place value is 4 here, plus 1 is 5. So this did do a division by 2. If it is an even number, it will do a clean division. It won't lose precision. However, if I was to apply another right shift, it would start to lose precision because 5 is odd. So if I was to do this again, this 1 in the right-hand side gets cut off. So the other 2 shift across, and I'm left with 1, 0 as my answer. You could fill in zeros if you wanted to here. Zeros on the left-hand side of a number don't matter. You'll see this in mark schemes quite often, but it doesn't matter if you put in the zeros on the left or not. What's important is what happens at the LSB. So this answer now is not 2.5 as it should be if it was doing a correct division. This answer is 2. So we can see this loss of precision in action. 0.5 has effectively been lost in this process. We lose some precision. Let's end by looking at 3 quick exam style questions to make sure this is all understood. So first of all, let's perform a left shift of 3 on this binary number and then state the effect of it. A really common 2-part question here. Well, the first part is quite simple. All I need to do for a left shift is copy my binary number and stick, in this particular case, 3 zeros on the right-hand side. In terms of the effect of this, well, it's either gonna be multiplying or dividing, and a left shift, we are multiplying. If it helps you memorize it, well, a left shift is making a number get bigger, then other digits are shifting to the left, therefore it is multiplying, not dividing. You can't just say that and leave it and move on. You've got to say by what amount. Well, each time I do a left shift, I'm timesing by 2. So me doing it 3 times in a row is doing times 2, times 2, times 2. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. The answer is I'm multiplying by 8. Really commonly people do, but they'd write down, say, multiplying by 6, because they assume it is 3 times 2, but it's not, it's powers of 2. And the general rule for shifting is it's either going to be multiplying or dividing by 2 to the power how many times you are shifting. Here I'm shifting 3 times, therefore it is timesing 2 to the power 3. That's really useful to keep in your mind. And we can use it in question 2 where we need to state the right shift required to divide this number by 4. It doesn't really matter what number this is in this question. What is the general shift to divide by 4? Well, I want to do divide by 2 to the power something is equal to 4. And the something in this case is 2. So therefore, I'm doing a right shift of 2. That would divide the number by 4. And 3 is a mirror of question 1, but for right shifts, we are performing a right shift of 4 on this binary number, and then I state the effect. So in this particular case, all I need to do is just cut off 4 digits on the right-hand side. It's not normally worth many marks for these questions, so there's not really marks for workings out. I can just not write down those 4 right-hand side digits. So what is the effect of this operation? Well, again, it's always, in this case, we're dividing by 2 to the power how many I'm doing. I'm doing 4 here, so therefore dividing by 2 to the power 4, which is 16. However, we can't just move on at this point because a right shift isn't quite as simple as a left shift. We always have to add that slight addition that we are dividing by 16, but removing the fractional part. So don't forget to add that whenever you're talking about right shifts.